Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen. Wa ali kulli masahabati ajma'een. Amma ba'd. I would like to share with you some spiritual productivity tips to help you to benefit from the month of Rajab. The month of Rajab is called Rajab al-Haram, means the sacred and the holy month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it's one of the four sacred months during which fighting is prohibited. It's also called Rajab al-Fard. That means it is the Rajab that is solitary from all other three holy months in the year. The other holy months we know, Dhul Qa'idha, Dhul Hijjah and Muharram. Okay, Rajab also witnessed the Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, subhanallah, such a miraculous night journey done by our master, beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which Allah honored him by that journey. Before Islam, the Arab used to slaughter a sacrifice during Rajab as an act of worship towards their idols. When Islam came, people were taught that sacrifices were to be offered only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, are we conscious about our actions in the beautiful month of Rajab? Because Rajab is called as the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in an authentic hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, Rajabun shakhrullah. Rajab is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Imagine if Allah says, this is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it should have a beautiful significance. It's nothing else that the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showering upon His obedience, upon His servants in this beautiful month of Rajab, greater than all other months of the year. I'll give you some of the tips that we can utilize in the beautiful month of Rajab. Number one, think about our intention, because this is the time we are preparing to welcome the beautiful month, the glorious month of the year, Ramadan, inshallah. We are planting the seeds on earth, on the soil of spirituality in this beautiful month of Rajab. So the intention is number one. Number two, seek forgiveness and forgive. We do abundance of astaghfirullah al-alim, istighfar in this beautiful month. At the same time, we should be ready to give forgiveness to our fellow brothers and sisters. We love forgiveness, of course. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always for forgiveness. As we know the beautiful dua, Allahumma innaka afuun, O Allah, you are the most forgiving. Tuhibbu al-afwa, and you love forgiveness. Fa'afu anni, and please forgive me. This is the same motto we have to utilize. We have to practice in the beautiful month of Rajab. Forgive one another and seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, fast some extra days. Okay, especially Mondays and Thursdays. Use those days to fast and get practice for Ramadan. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast a lot in the month of Rajab. Allahu Akbar. Number four, deprive yourself. Start training yourself to resist by not indulging in the things that your nafs desires. Deprive ourselves from the prohibited things and train ourselves to do a lot of hasanat in this beautiful month. And also, another beautiful thing, make a lot of du'as, especially the du'a of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us. What is that? Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, please shower upon us the abundance of your mercy in the beautiful months of Rajab and Sha'ban. Oh Allah, please make us rich to the glorious month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the tawfiq to fulfill the sunnahs of our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this beautiful month, and inshallah to get maximum benefits the month of Rajab and Sha'ban, and to welcome the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the tawfiq to increase the rood upon our beloved master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa azwajihi wa dhurriyatihi at-tayyibin wa alihi wa itratihi ila yawmiddin. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.